Hello everyone. Last class we have learned up to exercise 4.3. So now let us see exercise 4.4. Find a quotient and remainder. See 84 divided by 28. So now with 28 you have to divide 84. So 28 outside we will write and 84 inside we will write. So 28 table we don't know. So what we have to do, in the side you have to write the table. So 28 ones are 25. You have to multiply and you should write. So 28 2s are 56, 28 3s are 84. So now here you have 84, so 3 times it will go. So 28 3s are 84. So quotient is 3 and remainder is 0. So next same way you see 92 divided by 41. So 41 smaller number outside and bigger number inside. So now here also so same thing, 41 table you don't know. So you have to write 41 1s are 41, 41 2s are 82, 41 3s are 123. So here we have 92. So you can take 2 times. 41 2s are 82. So quotient is 2. Remainder is 10. So next is third one. 73 divided by 13. So smaller number outside, in bigger number inside. So you know 13 table. So 13 5s are 65. So 73 minus 65, 8. Quotient is 5. Remainder is 8. So same way 240 divided by 18. So smaller number outside, bigger number out inside, smaller number outside. So now here 18 table. So here 24 you have to take. So 18 ones are 18. So 24 minus 18, 6. Then the 0 you have to bring it down. So it will become 60. So 18 threes are 54. So 60 minus 54 gives us 6. So quotient is 13 and remainder is 6. Next, you see 613 divided by 24. 3-digit number with 2-digit. See, here also, first you don't know 24 table, so you have to write 24 table. 24 ones are 24, 24 twos are 48, 24 threes are 72, 24 fours are 96, 24 fives are 120. So now you can take two numbers here, 61. So now here how many times it will go? So we can take 2 times. 24 2s are 48. So 61 minus 48 gives us 13. And here which is left 3, you have to bring it down. 133. So now you can take 24 5s are 120. So 133 minus 120 gives us 13. So quotient is 25. Remainder is 13. So same way, see next one. 4-digit number with 2-digit. 6792 divided by 38. So here also same way you have to write the 38 table. 38 ones are 38, 38 twos are 76. So here this one how you have to write, means just you have to multiply and you should write. It's 38 into 2, 38 into 3, 38 into 4, like this you have to multiply and you should write first table. Then it will be very easy to divide here. So here see two numbers are there, 67 you have to take. So now you can see here how many times it will go, so only one time. So you can take 38 ones are 38. So 67 minus 38 gives us 29. And here which is there 9, you have to bring it down. Then it will become 299. So here 38 sevens are 266. You have to write 7 up 266. So 299 minus 266 gives us 33. Then one more number, 2 is there. This you have to bring it down. 332. So now you can take 38 eights are 304. So 332 minus 304. It gives 26. So quotient is 178. Remainder is 26. So this is the way you will divide 2-digit or 3-digit or 4-digit by 4-digit number by with 2-digit numbers. So now let us see division by 10, 100, and 1000. So in case if it is like 10, 100, 1000, so how you have to divide? See here they have given 186 divided by 10. So here one easy method you can remember what is this means. So whatever it is there, the last one, last digit. So that one will be remainder and remaining before numbers you will get as a quotient. So let us see here, 10, 186 you should divide by 10. So 10 ones are 10, 18 minus 10 you will get 8 and 6 you have to bring it down. So then 10 8s are 80, 86 minus 86. So as I said, so last number you will get as remainder and before two numbers you will get as quotient. So quotient is 18, remainder is 6. Same way you can see here also 1234 divided by 10. So here the last digit you will get as remainder. 4 is a remainder. 123 is quotient. So if you want you can divide and say 10 ones are 10. 12 minus 10, 2. Then 3 you have to bring it down. 10 twos are 20. Then 23 minus 23, 4 you have to bring it down. 10 threes are 34. So as I said, remainder will be 4 and quotient will be 123. Same way here also, 235 if you divide with 100. So here what will happen means, so last two numbers you will get as a remainder and before numbers you will get as quotient. 100 2s are 200. So 35 is a remainder and quotient is 2. Same way here also you can see 4685. So here you will get 85 as remainder and before number as a quotient. So same way when you are dividing with 1000. So 3565. Last three digits you will get as a remainder and before that digits you will get as quotient. Same thing here also. 48693. Last three digits you will get as remainder. Before numbers you will get as a quotient. See here. When a number is divided by 10, remainder, the digit in the ones place. So you have to remember when you are dividing with a 10, so the remainder will be in the ones place. And quotient made up by the rest of the digits. So same way when a number is divided by 100, remainder what you will get means made up by the digits in the tens and ones place. So when you are dividing with 10 means remainder will be ones place. And when you are dividing with 100, the remainder will be tens and ones place. Remaining will be as a quotient. So same way when you are when your number is divided by 1000, remainder made up by the digits in the hundreds, tens and ones place. So when you are dividing with 1000, hundreds, tens, ones. So that three numbers will be as a remainder and rest of the numbers you will get as a quotient. Next is the story sums. 48 boxes of apples can be loaded in a truck. How many trucks are required to load 6000 boxes? So this is how to do division. See here, number of boxes is 48. So in 48 boxes, it will be one truck it can load. So now here, what you have to find in 6000 boxes, how many apples you, that means 6000 boxes. So in how many trucks you can load it. So what you have to do, 6000 divided by 48. See, 48 boxes can be loaded in one truck. So 6000 boxes can be loaded in 6000 divided by 48 trucks. So 6000 when you are dividing with 48. So 48. So here two digits you have to take 60. 48 ones are 48. 60 minus 48, 12 you will get. And this 0 you have to bring it down. So 120 it will become. Then 48 twos are 96. 120 minus 96 will become 24. And this remain, well, this last 0 you have to bring down. Then it will become 240. So 48 fives are 240. So 240 minus 240 is 0. So the answer you will get as 125. So in 125 trucks, you can load 6000 boxes. Next, see, the cost of a calculator is 65 rupees. So calculator, one calculator cost is 65 rupees. How many calculators can Mrs. Joseph buy for 2400 rupees? So if one calculator costs 65 rupees, so 2400 rupees, for 2400 rupees, how many calculators he can buy? How much money will be left with her? So that means you have to divide 2400 divided by 65. See, for 65 rupees, number of calculators. So that means cost of one calculator is 65 rupees. And for 2400 rupees, how many calculators we have to buy? So that means 2400 divided by 65 you have to do. So division 65, 2400 you should divide with 65. So 65 threes are 195. 240 minus 195 will get 45. Then this 0 you have to bring down. Then it will become 450. 65 sixes are 390. So 450 minus 390, 60. If you minus, you will get 60. So now here, the answer you will get as 36. So that means in 2400 rupees, you will get 36 calculators and the money will left 60 rupees. So this is the way you will do the story sums. Next you see here, add, subtract, multiply or divide. See, some word problems are given. Do not work out any problem, but read through the problems carefully. So what you have to do, you shouldn't work out here. Just you have to read the sums carefully. Fill in the box provided, write down A if it is an addition problem. Suppose if that problem is addition means you have to write A. If it is subtraction, write yes. And if it is multiplication, you have to write M. And if it is division, you have to write D. So for addition sum, you have to write A. For subtraction, you have to write S. For multiplication, you have to write M. And for division, you have to write D. So you no need to work. Just in the provided box, if you write, it is enough. A, S, M, or D. See the first question. In a cycle stand, there are 236 girls' bicycles and 150 boys' bicycles. How many bicycles are there in all? So in a cycle stand, boys' bicycles you have, girls' cycles also you have. So 236 girls, 150 boys. So now you have what they have asked, how many bicycles are there in all? So all together, boys plus girls, how many is there you have to find. So that means if you add, you will get. So this is the addition sum. So you can write in the box, A. So next, Babu is 34 years old. Ram is 18 years. How much older is Babu than Ramu? So here you can say 34 years, this is a elder, and 18 years this is younger. So from elder to younger, if you from bigger number to smaller number, if you minus, you will get how much he is older. So this is a subtraction sum. You can write yes. I have 20 rupees in my purse. How many paisa do I have? So you know that 1 rupee equals to 100 paisa. So here 20 rupees you have to change in, you have to convert into paisa. So that means what you have to do? 20 into 100 you have to do. So this is a multiplication sum. Next, fourth one. You have 65 rupees. How many 5 rupee stamps can you buy? So 65 rupees you have. 5 rupee stamps you have to buy. So for 65 rupees, how many 5 rupee stamps you can buy? So that means 65 divided by 5. If you do, you will get. So this is a division sum. Next, fifth one. There are 120 marbles. Each boy gets 6 marbles. How many boys are there? So here, total 120 marbles are there. And one boy will get 6 marbles. So how many boys are there? So one boy will get 6 marbles. So how many boys are there? You have to find. So what you should do? 120 divided by 6. If you do, you will get. So this is also division sum. Next, last one. There are 24 lines on each page. So that means in a notebook for one page, 24 lines are there. If there are 100 pages in the book, how many lines are there in all? So in a book, 100 pages. So for one page, 24 lines means for 100 pages, how many lines are there? So what you should do, 100 into 24 you have to do. So this is a multiplication sum. Next is a unitary method. The unitary method is a technique for solving a problem by first finding the value of a single unit and then finding the necessary value by multiplying the single unit value. In essence, this method is used to find the value of a unit from the value of multiple and hence the value of a multiple. See here, finding the value of required quantity by first finding the value of 1. So that means first you have to find 1 item cost. Then what you have to do, how many they have asked. So that into cost of 1, if you multiply, you will get. See here, 5 strawberries cost is 15 rupees. See here, 5 strawberries cost, they have given 15 rupees. So now what you have to do, first you have to find the cost of 1 strawberry. So what you have to do, 15 divided by 5, if you do, you will get. So cost of 1 strawberry equals to, so cost of 5 strawberries divided by number of strawberries. So that means 15 by 5. So 3 rupees you will get. So one, cost of 1 strawberry is 3 rupees. So now what you have to find? Value of required quantity. So how many they have all that you have to find. So value of 1 item into required quantity. So cost of 8 strawberries they have asked. It means 8 into cost of 1 strawberry, 3. So 3 into 8. So 24. So cost of 8 strawberries is 24 rupees. So like this you will find in unitary method. So first in unitary method what you have to do? First you have to find the cost of 1 thing. Next what you should do? So you have to find out how many they have given. Number of items into cost of 1 thing. So if you do in such a way you will get the answer. This is called unitary method. So now you see based on these sums. Fill in the blanks to solve the story sums. A maths test paper has 10 questions and the total marks are 100. So maths test paper they have given. So in that question paper you have 10 questions and for 10 questions there are 100 marks. If Ritu answers 6 questions correctly, how many marks will she get? So she answered only 6 correct out of 10. So how many marks she will get? You have to find. See how you are going to solve this sum. So total marks for 10 questions. So for 10 questions how many marks? 100 marks. Marks for 1 question. So now here 10 questions marks they have given. So first what we have to find? 1 question mark we have to find. So that means number of marks divided by number of questions. So 100 divided by 10. 10 tens are 100. So for 1 question, each question they will be having 10 marks. Now marks for 6 questions. So what you have to do? Marks of 1 question into number of questions. 10 into 60, 60 marks. So hence Ritu will get 60 marks. Same way, second one, Ravi painted 48 meters of a fence in 6 days. How much did he paint in the first 4 days? See here, fence painted in 6 days. So in 6 days, how many meters he painted? 48 meters. Now what you have to find? So 6 days he painted 48 meters. Now in 1 day, how many meters you have to do? So fence painted in 1 day. So what you should do? Number of meters divided by number of days. 48 divided by 6. So that means for 1 day, he will paint 8 meters. Now fence painted in how many days they have asked? 4 days. So 4 into number of how many meters he did in 1 day. 4 into 8. So 4 8s are 32. 32 meters. So now Ravi painted 32 meters in 4 days. So same way third one. It takes 72 minutes to fill 12 buckets of water. How much time will it take to fill 9 buckets? See here, 72 minutes, 12 buckets of water will fill. So now first what you have to do, you have to find one bucket, how many minutes it takes. Time taken to fill 12 buckets equals to 72 minutes. Time taken to fill one bucket, what you should do, 72 divided by 12. So 12 6 are 72, so one to fill one bucket, it takes 6 minutes. Now time taken to fill 9 buckets, so here they have asked 9 buckets. So time taken for one bucket into 9 into 6, so you will get 54 minutes. So to fill 9 buckets, you will take 54 minutes time. So this is the way we will solve in unitary method. So next, see, based on this only, again you have your problems. The cost of 1 dozen pencils is 24 rupees. What is the cost of 1 pencil cost? See here, cost of 12 pencils, they have given here 24. So now you have to find cost of 1 pencil. So 24 divided by 12. 12 twos are 24. So cost of 1 pencil is 2 rupees. And so if the cost of many articles is given, you have to find the cost of one article. You divide first here. You have to find 1 pencil cost. So there can be situation where the cost of 1 dozen articles is given and you want to buy 7 articles. So how do you find the cost of 7 articles? So that means what you will do, cost of 1, 9 to 7. So that means 2 into 7. Then you will get 14. So in such a way. Next, you see, a dozen notebooks cost 120 rupees. How much will 7 notebooks cost? So you know that cost of 1 dozen means 12 things. So that means 12 notebooks cost is 120 rupees. The cost of 12 notebooks is 120 rupees. So first you have to find cost of 1 notebook equals to 120 divided by 12. So 12 tens are 120. So that means 1 notebook cost is 10 rupees. And here they have asked to find out 7 notebooks. The cost of 7 notebooks equals to cost number of notebooks into cost of 1 notebook. So 7 into 10 rupees. That means 70 rupees. So in this way, you will find the cost of notebooks. Okay, so I hope you all understood this chapter. Thank you.